Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our international referees for this match. Your first referee from Puerto Rico, Arnaldo Pinero. Your second referee from Guatemala, Geraldo Cifuentes. And now, let's meet the starting lineups. First, for Team Dominican Republic. Number two, Calvin Antonio Campuchano. Number three, Elvis Contreras. Number four, Wilfredo Hernandez. Number nine, Luis David Adamas. Number 12, Cesar Jr. Alcantara. Number 15, Henry Omar Tapia. And the libero, number 5, Jose Alejandro Castillo. Lead coach for Team Dominican Republic, Mr. Ociel Vasquez. Team Dominican Republic. And now, here are your starters for Team USA. Number one, Matthew Anderson. Number eight, William Pretty. Number 11, Micah Christensen. Number 15, Carson Clark. Number 17, Maxwell Holt. Number 21, Foodi Tavana. And your libero, number 22, Eric Schoche. Lead coach for Team USA, Mr. John Spira. Team USA.
Jeff Sargent and Kyle Donan with you here, and we're just about set to get underway. The final match, the premier match of the day, Kyle. The United States taking on the Dominican Republic, and we were just noting about how the United States in particular, a very different roster than what we saw yesterday in their opening match against St. Lucia.
Yeah, very different. I'm not sure if that's their strategy, but a different lineup nonetheless. Matt Anderson checking in for one as for his first action all tournament. A couple of these guys were in there for a few points, but for the most part they went with a very different lineup to start, so it'll be interesting to see how they bounce back getting their first taste of action here.
And the most notable insertion to the lineup of Matt Anderson, as you mentioned, William Pretty didn't play a whole lot yesterday, although he did see some action.
Yeah, and he's the veteran presence on this team. Something the U.S. has over the Dominican for age. It's a very different, very big difference in age here. A very young team on the Dominican side. Really one major veteran player in the server who's going to get us started here with the match.
And that is Elvis Contreras, 34 years old, definitely one of the oldest, as you say, on the Dominican team.
Yeah, well, watching him swing in warm-up, he didn't look like his 34-year-old shoulder was hurting him too bad. He was hitting the ball harder than anybody else on the floor.
And we're set to get underway. It's the United States' second match. They had a straight set sweep over St. Lucia yesterday. And again, they'll be looking for those key points here as it's set up for Pretty. And they'll get the point as it was knocked out of bounds off Tapia. 1-0. The United States strikes first. And again, the point differential to get that bye into the semis. Cuba doing a great favor for Canada going to a fourth set.
Yeah, it really kind of changes the outcome for both sides with the U.S. Having a chance to clinch their spot after this match today. It'll obviously depend on how Canada does tomorrow for the overall finish in those standings for the top spots. But, I mean, the Americans, if they do beat Dominican today, they most likely will have a spot in that semifinals on Friday.
So Pretty serve sails right out of bounds, and now the Dominican getting their first point of the match, and they're back to serve. Sends it towards the back of the court, set up by Christensen, tipped over by Pretty. And a nice dig there by Sochi, but the Americans having trouble getting it back in play. And Foodi Tavana can't quite get there, so it will be the Dominican getting the point, 2-1, an early lead. And serving for the Dominican, Kelvin Campanchano. And I was going to say one of the younger guys, but it is a young team. Yeah, he's 21 years old, not off the average.
It's a very young team. A lot of the players on the Dominican Republic were at the under 23 tournament last year that was held, the Pan American Cup. So a very similar team. Really the only big difference is number three on their side, who's one of the oldest players, as we mentioned, Contreras. So it'd be interesting to see what kind of a role he plays and what he brings to this young group.
And now a 3-1 lead for the Dominican is the play at the net. Campanchano serving again, set at the front by Christensen and Tavana with a power slam. And the Americans now within one, and they'll get the serve back. Holt checking in as the libero will sit down while Tavana serves. And Tavana, we were talking about this yesterday, Claire and I, he's a new member of the national team for the United States. Still playing college.
Yeah, he doesn't look like it, though. He's a big boy, and he doesn't look out of place in this group at all.
Nice block at the net by Christensen, and the Americans get the point, and they've tied it at three. So Tavana to serve again. Hailing from Hawaii, he plays for Brigham Young University. And he'll take his time before putting the serve over the net. Going for the dig was pretty, but point going to the Dominican. Back in the lead, 4-3. And what I've noticed in a lot of the matches so far, Kyle, really it's very close, tight match until the first set timeout, and then one team tends to kind of run away with it a little bit.
Yeah, so far it has kind of been like that, I would say. One of the things, though, with these teams, and once we get deeper and deeper into the tournament, the games are going to get closer and closer. And because, I mean, in these pool play matches, a lot of the structure of it is that it's a higher-ranked team against a few lower-ranked teams, so generally there is that bit of separation. And so far, it's played out like that so far, too.
Micah Christensen serving. Set at the front of the net for Tapia, but a block by Holt. 5-4, the Americans with a one-point lead, and Christensen will hold serve.
That's a big block to go after on that right side. You got to make a bit of a higher swing, I think. Those are two big arms on that outside.
And Christensen across. Set up at the front of the net, and just in, says the far linesman. So point will go to the Dominican. Cesar Alcantara. And set. Tied up at five, and it will be Luis Adames now serving for the Dominican Republic. Definitely the underdog in this match, but trying to give the United States a bit of a run for their money here. Christensen sets it up at the far side, and getting the point for the States, Matt Anderson. It's his first point, yeah, first attack of this match, of this tournament.
First big kill, and again, it's a bit of a surprise, but he didn't play in that first match. And I'm sure they'll be looking to get him going, as he's generally been one of their starting players. So I'm sure they'll be looking to get him on fire a little bit so that he feels comfortable heading into the next couple matches.
And he is serving. Set at the front. Play whistled down. Point will go to the Dominican. And we're tied up at six. Hernandez. Wilfredo Hernandez now serving. Lobs it high in the air, but a net serve. And the United States gets the point back, gets the ball back. And Holt now serving for the first time at the tournament. Did not play yesterday.
And it's been a bit of a slow start to this first set. No real emotion from either side, and as we've seen on a lot of these matches, that usually plays a big role.
Nice dig by Holt, set by Christensen. Pretty with the attack, and he gets the point. 8-6, and at the first time out, the United States opening up a two-point lead for the first time in the match. And we'll take a quick break here with the United States up by two in this first set. Jeff Sargent, Kyle Donan here inside the Langley Events Center. The United States up 8-6 over the Dominican Republic in this first set. The U.S. easily taking care of St. Lucia yesterday, 25-12, 25-10, 25-11. And this is the first match of the tournament for the Dominican.
And it's a tough task to have your first match be against the U.S. U.S. ranked fifth in the world, so a tough task for Dominican. But so far, they've met the challenge. It's only a two-point advantage. Very close here to start the game. They don't seem to be uncomfortable at all.
But like we were saying, this is sort of the point when one team is so often pulled away, but the Dominican comes within one as Holt sends a serve straight into the net. So serving for the Dominican Republic, Cesar Alcantara. Not one of the taller members of the team, and we'll see if he goes for an aggressive serve or not. Gets it over nicely, and a point will go to the Dominicans. Play at the net by Campanchano. 8-8, we're all tied up.
Back and forth match so far, as the U.S. almost looks like they don't look as comfortable as they did yesterday, but again, when you change the lineup up like that, sometimes it's harder to get that that rhythm back.
Kabula over to the far side, a double block by the Americans. Tavana, 9-8, getting a little fired up now, Kyle. We're seeing a lacking emotion to this point, but I think they're trying, kind of settling into the match. They realize it's a close one. So
that must have been what they talked about in that technical timeout. You know, we need some emotion. We got to have some energy, and that's what's done really well in this tournament for teams that have won.
And a service ace for the United States, Carson Clark, with his first serve of the tournament and just painting the line.
Yeah, the Dominican coach didn't look like he completely agreed with the calls. He had a couple words for the linesman there.
10-8, the Americans up, and that one is definitely out. So the point will go back to the Dominicans. It's a one-point match, 10-9, the U.S. leading. And again, we got to keep in mind those the point differential. And Canada right now looking good in that department, only allowing 30 against in their first match. And that serve from Contreras will head straight out of bounds. So the U.S. back up by 2, 11-9. William Pretty to serve for the United States. Sit by Kubula at the front of the net. Nice block by the Americans, Anderson, but it's out of bounds, and the point going to the Dominicans, so they keep right at it, and they're within one once again.
Yeah, this young Dominican team has done a good job so far. They've stayed very composed. Must have helped that this same group played here last year. You know, they look very comfortable in this environment. They played on this court before, and they know what it's all about.
Cappuccino serving, set by Christensen. Contreras. Well back of the baseline, gets it up to Tapia, sends it over the net, set by Christensen again. Tavana fakes Pretty with the slam, just in, again, very close to that baseline, but point going to the Americans, 12-10.
Yeah, close is good enough when it comes to it, especially when he was attempting to stay behind that 3-meter line. He was very close to going over, but as long as you stay just behind it, that's exactly what you want as a power hitter coming through that pipe position.
Futi Tavana serving for the Americans, trying to go up by 3 for the first time this match. Tapia has to get that over the net, and he does. Now the Americans will set it up. Christensen over for Anderson, and a nice dig by Tapia, and a block by Anderson. Still in play, but they're going to have to get it over the net. Point immediately given to the Americans. 4 touches by the Dominicans, and now there's your 3-point lead on an error by the Dominican.
Yeah, that's one of the rarer rallies we seem to have had so far, and a smart timeout here. I like this timeout by the Dominican coach. It's you know, it's a perfect time. This is the first time we've seen a bit of a spread, so it's a good time to do it and slow everything down where you can.
I guess another tactic that it looks like I've seen some of the other matches is, but typically close to the end of a set, is to a quick substitution to sort of, especially if a server has gotten into a bit of a groove, just to break things up a little bit.
Yeah, that is one of the perfect times, and what you like to call that if the server goes up and misses after that is you call it almost a coach's point, because the coach is making that call to mess everything up, you could say, mess up that rhythm, and anything you can throw at him is the time to do it. And I think this is a good call for a Dominican coach, especially if they earn this point back. You know, with the team they're playing against, they don't want to give too much separation to the Americans. The Americans are one of the stronger teams in this tournament. And right now, the Dominicans are in a good spot to push for this set. You never know what can happen. So this was a good time to try and slow them down.
So coming out of the team timeout by the Dominican, Tavana to serve for the U.S. with a three-point lead. It's 13-10, set number one. Only one match so far has gone to more than three sets, and that was the last one, Cuba, coming out with the lead. Tavana set by Christensen. Sent right back over Cabrula to the front of the net. That's Hernandez. Set up for Tapia towards the back of the court. Tipped out of bounds. Point going to the Dominican. They're back within two.
Yeah, good point there for the Dominican. A hard-fought battle to earn that one. And after the timeout, exactly what the coach wanted to see after the timeout. Earn the point back and get to within two.
Tapia now serving for the Dominicans. Trying to get within one. Soji now set at the front of the net. Holt with the kill. And the Americans now opening up that three-point lead. 14-11. Christensen serving.
Dominicans need to get it back here, and then they need a defensive stop to try and get back to within a point or two.
Aggressive serve towards the back of the court, up for Tapia, and it's tipped out of bounds, so the Dominican hanging in there, 14-12, still a close match.
Yeah, it's been a good side-out game for both teams here. Not very many runs, as you said. Like just that one bit of separation for the Americans here with it being 14-10 early.
Adamas serving Soji, first touch, set by Christensen. Matt Anderson, but recovered now by the Dominican. Play at the net. Point will go to the Dominican. Falling down on the American side, so now within one, the Dominican Republic, 14-13.
Yeah, great dig in the back row, and then to finish it off, goes with the pipe swing, and it just squeezes through. Perfect timed hit for the Dominican.
Luis Adamas serving yet again. Set Christensen. Holt going down and gets the point. 15-13, the United States back up front by two. And it will be Anderson serving for the United States. He'll take his time. Towards the back of the court. Libero touching it first. Cabrula. Now they'll have to send that back over the net. And they do. Soji set by Christensen. And a block at the front of the net. Hernandez. And the Dominican gets the point. Still a one-point game now. 15-14. And the Dominican getting the serve back with Hernandez.
Yeah, some good fight here from the Dominican in this first set as they've kind of jumped on the U.S. a little bit. Almost a bit of a surprise to the Americans where the Dominicans have them.
Christensen to set once again and a block at the net by Campuchano. And we're all tied at 15.
Yeah, this young, feisty Dominican team has given all kinds of problems to the Americans here. Tied up just before going into this technical timeout.
Hernandez with the serve, sets it right out of bounds. So the United States will take that lead, 16-15 at the second technical timeout in this first set. We'll take a quick break here at the Langley Event Center. The U.S. with a one-point lead, 16-15 over the Dominican. And Kyle, what have you liked so far from the underdog Dominicans, which don't really look like an underdog right now?
You know what? I don't think they haven't backed down. You know, they're up against a tough team, and they've played aggressive. They've done some really good things at the front of the net. And so far, they're staying right with one of the better teams in the world.
Holt has his serve returned immediately, but then the U.S. sending it right back with the kill. 17-15, now 2-point lead. The U.S. has led by 3, the largest margin, though, so far of the match. And Holt still serving for the Americans. Tips it just over the net. Kabula set up for Tapia. Block at the net, but still in play. Dominicans looking for the hole. Holt returns it immediately. Set by Kabula at the front of the net. Point will go to the Dominicans as Christensen had to go awkwardly off his forearms. 17-16. Alcantara serving for the home team Dominicans here in this match. Christensen sets up for Tavana. Nice block at the net. Still in play. Kabula. Towards the back of the court. Soji. Set it up towards the front for the Americans. Pretty. Nearly tipped out but kept in play. Nice volley action here. Christensen. Tavana puts it over. But a double touch called by the referee. And the Dominicans get the point. And we're tied up at 17. Longest volley so far.
Yeah, one of the longer rallies we've seen. And that's usually what gets players into the match. And you know, it's a great start for the Dominicans here. I really like what they've been doing at the net. They've been getting some really good touches, giving themselves a chance to swing offensively, and so far they're being really rewarded for it.
Just getting the serve over the net, set up. Kabula. Now for Tapia, pretty going up, gets the block. 18-17, and the U.S. back in front by 1.
Yeah, close match here, 18-17. I think a lot of the fans that are here wouldn't have expected it to be this close, but I've been really impressed with what the Dominicans have brought to the table here.
Serving the Americans now. And just inside the Americans, Carson Clark with the ace, 19-17. And a timeout called by the Dominicans. And Kyle, again, just trying to disrupt the United States here before they get out to any bigger lead.
Yeah, I think he senses, you know, it's that time again where it looked like the U.S. were going to pull away just ever so slightly. You know, a couple miscues on the last few points for the Dominican. But other than that, I think they've played a very solid game, and their game plan against the U.S. has looked very, very impressive so far.
19-17, the Americans with the lead. One of the favorites in the tournament, along with Cuba and Canada.
Yeah, don't forget Canada.
Of course not. Canada, though, looking for that first gold and maybe prime for a first time?
Yeah, I definitely think so. With what they've done over the summer, you know, moving up from 18th to 11th in the world, that's a big jump. They've had some great success, and doing that in this tournament would be a great way to finish off the summer.
Clark won't get the ace this time as we come back from the timeout just inside, painting the line at the back. Point for the Dominican in 19-18, and they continue to keep close. Contrera now serving for the Dominican. Aggressive serve set by Christensen. Pretty, but a block by Capitano. And now the Dominicans have tied it at 19.
Yeah, just like they did the last time they took a big timeout early in this set. They were down a few points, and they earned them right back after their timeout. That's got to be an impressive feeling for both the players and the coach.
Elvis Contrera. Soji, first touch set by Christensen. Tavana with the kill. U.S. staying in front. They just won't let the Dominicans take the lead. They come close. but then the Americans going ahead once again.
Yeah, a strong pass there from Soji gave every option to his setter, and that makes it really hard on the Dominicans to chase after that set. With the speed that they play at this level, it's almost impossible when that set comes perfectly. You got to guess right.
Pretty serving. Block at the net by Christensen, kept in play. Soji. Christensen set to Vanna, fake, and Anderson slams it down, gets the point. So 21-19, the Americans up by two.
Yeah, they're chipping away now. As, you call it tough at 20. You get the 20 points, and you almost go into that extra gear to finish it off, kind of like lunging in the 100 meters to finish off the game, finish off the race.
Pretty serving for the Americans. No more timeouts, mind you, either for the Dominicans as the ball goes out of play. First touch by Jose Castillo, the libero for the Dominican, and now a three-point lead by the United States.
Strong serving from Pretty. The first serve he had in this match, he didn't take a big swing on it, but all of a sudden he's really changed up his momentum on his serve.
Pretty. Serve over clean. Americans return it immediately. Cappuccino sending it down. Soji, first touch, now to Vanna. Anderson, towards the back of the court, still in play. Kabula. Play at the net. The Americans send it down, finding that big hole in the far side of the court. Castillo can't get there in time. And the Americans now up by four, their largest margin of the set.
Yeah, this is really the first time we've seen some solid back and forth and defense from the U.S. claiming that extra lead here. And they've done a really good job in the later stages of the set.
Pretty's strung together a nice few serves with another one. Castillo, first touch. Tapia. And it's tipped outside. No, the U.S. will get credit for the point. So it is set point, 24-19. Pretty still with the serve. Castillo, first touch. Kabula. Bit of a trick play to send it over the net. Soji, first touch. Pretty slamming it down. First touch by Castillo sends the ball high. Block at the front of the net. Tavana, U.S. gets the point. They take the first set, 25-19. And we'll take a quick break and come back to set up set number two here, but the U.S. striking first over the Dominican Republic.
From Elgin High School, I have Connor, Nolan, Thomas, and Angus here, and they are going to be peppering against each other. Whoever can keep the ball up the longest will win. And I'm going to get you guys to line up this way along the court. Take your positions and get ready for my go. For those of you who don't know, pepper is basically a warm-up volleyball drill where you bump, pass, and spike at your partner. When you guys are ready, on your mark, get set, go. They're doing well so far. These guys have played volleyball before. Oh, it's looking troublesome. Oh, and we have a winner on the side. That was close, but congratulations, Connor and Nolan. You guys have won Mr. Mike's gift cards. And who are you guys cheering tonight at this game for? Who are you cheering for?
What?
Who are you cheering for tonight?
Team USA!
USA.
Awesome. Well, it looks like they're on their way to a win. Congratulations, guys.
Thank you.
Jeff Sargent and Kyle Donan back with you here live at the Langley Events Center. The United States up 1-0 over the Dominican Republic, 25-19. And Kyle, again, we saw the two really staying close, and then the Americans pulled away just at the end.
Yeah, it was very close. I think the Dominicans got to be happy with their performance in that that first set. You know, a few letdowns down the stretch at the later stages, but at the same time, you know, they were right there. They had an opportunity to take it, and the U.S. did a good job of kicking it into an extra gear in the last few points and taking it. Only 25-19. I think it was a little bit closer than what that score even showed.
Yeah, definitely was, and we didn't really see a whole lot of long, you know, there was not a lot of long volley action. There was not a lot of returns, not a lot of service aces, mind you, either, but that was a rather quick first set considering how many points were scored. So Pretty leads things off for the Americans. And he's going to have to get the ball back in play. Soji's got to set this one up at the front. Clark tipped at the front of the net, but now it is Tapia who slams it down, gets the kill just in front of Pretty, who seemed a little unprepared. 1-0 here in the second set, striking first the Dominicans.
Yeah, it looked like that swing caught the seam. And when you're caught in that six-back position where Pretty was, if it goes through that seam, that's a very tough ball to read where it's going to go. So he kind of threw his hands up like, I don't know, what am I going to do? Because that's a tough ball to recover from.
And sending the ball straight into the net, Campuchano. So the United States on the board, 1-1. And Footing Tavana now serving. Takes a deep breath before letting the ball away. And getting the point, Hernandez. Christensen bounces it off his forearm, but not able to control it. 2-1 for the Dominican.
Yeah, Hernandez has done a really good job. He's been successful with each hit that he's had so far tonight. He's done a good job blocking at the net. The only thing is when one of your stronger players is that middle position, you're only in there for part of the time.
And he's serving. Got it over cleanly. Tipped out of bounds off of Adamas, so the Americans getting the point back. Tied up at 2, Christensen serving. And we saw yesterday Christensen had a lot of success against St. Lucia. They just could not return his serves. You see the power he put on it. A little too much gas, though. And sends it right outside the back end of the court, so the Dominicans with the point. Henry Tapia serving for the Dominicans. They have a 1-point lead, 3-2. Aggressive serve, pretty first touch set up by Christensen. Tapia set by Christensen again, and a block at the front of the net, but the point will go to the Americans as it was off the fingers of Campuchano and out of play.
Now, the good thing is, though, for the Dominicans starting off in this set, too, is, you know, it's close. It's not like it looks one-sided in any way. I think the Dominicans have done a really good job staying composed, even after losing the last few points in that first set.
Anderson will get the ace, but it was going to head out of bounds.
Yeah,
and
Castillo was trying to get
there
out of the way.
Yeah, little too slow, and so he helped out the U.S. there. 4-3, the U.S. taking the lead. Service called, and Anderson.
Unfortunately, that serve was cutting towards where he was trying to turn away from, so caught him in the wrong spot.
Tapia gets it over, set by Christensen. And now up for Clark, and a good dig by Contreras. Sent over the net, but out of bounds off of the Americans. Actually, it was just inside on the line there. 4-4, tied up. Adamas serving for the Dominicans. And again, tight start to the set, as we saw in set number one. Anderson, first touch up for Christensen. Clark. Contreras sets it back to the center of the net. And just volleyed over by Adamas. Americans having trouble getting it over, though. Pretty, and tipped out of bounds off of Adamas. So the Americans getting the point and bailing themselves out 5-4.
That was a big swing on the outside for Pretty, an aggressive one. It had some pieces of tape fly off the hands of Capuchano in the middle. He's got every finger taped, but on that one, must have clipped the wrong finger because some tape came flying out.
Max Holt now serving for the U.S. Gets the ace as it bounces right off Castillo's left forearm and out of bounds. 6-4, the Americans have opened up a two-point lead.
Now this is that time where we saw the Dominicans take a timeout in that last set. We'll see if they can stay composed and kind of get back into it here after a good run for the Americans.
Max Holt again with the serve, but sends it into the net, point to the Dominicans. 6-5, the U.S., their lead down to 1. Kelvin Campuchano serving. Towards the back of the court, Soji set by Christensen. Pretty finds a hole, but a nice dig by Tapia. Now Contreras, block attempt by the Americans, but it doesn't go over on the other side, hitting the floor, 6-6, and Pretty doesn't like the call. He's going to have a word with the official.
Yeah, he wanted that ball to be down. He didn't think the Dominicans got that on the pancake dig. It's one of the tougher ones to see sometimes as an official. There are definitely times where that call goes the wrong way. Whether you get it or not, it can kind of, unfortunately, not go your way all the time.
Campuchano's serve. Pretty trying for the kill there, and now kept in. Pretty trying again. Block at the front of the net. Americans keep it in play. Tavana slamming it down, getting the point. 7-6, the Americans take the lead.
Now, good battle, though, at the front of the net. Pretty doing a good job swinging aggressively, and when he doesn't have a chance to score, he's using those hands and kind of rebounding it back to himself, giving himself a second chance.
Clark, aggressive serve. Handle at the front of that. Tapia going for the kill. Clark getting second touch, sent back over. Now set for Capuchano. And the Americans send it out of bounds. 7-7, we're tied. Alcantara with the serve out of bounds. So the U.S. with the point, 8-7. And that brings us to our first technical timeout. The United States with the one-point lead. Jeff Sargent, Kyle Donan here. It's coming out of the first technical timeout, second set. The United States took the first, 25-14. The Dominicans trailing by one. It's 8-7, the United States. Pretty serving as we come out of the timeout. Service called. Aggressive serve, Adamas, first touch, and unable to control it. 9-7.
Now this is that edge the Americans are looking for, and if Pretty can continue to serve strongly as he's done all match long so far, it's going to be the perfect time for the Americans to take an advantage.
Castillo, the libero, first touch. Hernandez. Set up by Alcantara. Tapia going for the kill, and it's tipped out of bounds off Christensen. So 9-8, and once again within one are the Dominicans. Contreras,
yeah,
serving.
A smart swing off those hands. I think that's something the Dominicans got to do a little bit more of, Use those hands when they're there. There's some big blocks on the other side for the Americans.
Big serve for the Dominicans. Pretty with the big slam down. Nice kill. 10-8. The Americans have their two-point lead back. Tavana to serve for the Americans. And you just see how big he is and all that power. It's a big body. Castillo has it go over on his first touch for the Dominicans. But a play at the net keeps the point and the serve for the Americans, who've now gone up 11-8.
Yeah, sometimes those float serves, they look a lot easier to the eye rather than the actual passer themselves. When they got no spin on that ball, it's very hard to figure out where it's going to go.
Adamas. Contreras has it go out of bounds. Point for the U.S. Now 12-8.
Now this is the time for the Dominicans. They got to, well, there you go. They take the timeout they need. Perfect timing. They got to slow it down where they can.
I was just about to say, you know, I kind of expecting a timeout here, and he was waiting and then took it. So, but they trailed by 4, and the Americans look to be gaining some steam here in the second set.
Yeah, it's, I think, almost like the first set was a bit of a warm-up for some of those guys who hadn't had a chance to play yesterday. They did look a little bit slower than what we would have thought, but they look a lot more comfortable in this second set, as you mentioned. And right now the Dominicans just got to find their groove. Their passing is what's starting to fail them a little bit here. And as soon as your passing breaks down in this game, it becomes very difficult to get it back. Something they did very well in that first set. And ironically, you know, last year their passing was probably their Achilles heel, and right now it's been a good part of their game, but right now they need to find a way to get it back.
So coming out of the team timeout for the Dominican, it is Tavana still with the serve for the U.S. Adamas for Contreras, blocked at the net by the Americans, still in play. Tapia sends it over. Tavana to set. And Clark has it land just in bounds. Now 13-8 lead for the U.S.
Yeah, tough ball there for the Dominicans as that first swing from Contreras was going off those hands and out of bounds. Well, his teammate just got caught in the way, and sometimes when it's right there in your hands, it's hard to make yourself shorter or get out of the way.
Tavana sends it over the net. Adamas. Blocked by the Americans, and Castillo with the initial touch, but not enough bounce on it, and it's now the Americans opening up a substantial lead, 14-8 now.
Yeah, it's starting to get away from the Dominican Republic here, as they need to side out this big serve from Tavana.
Castillo. Now for Adamas, blocked at the net again, the Americans, Holt. 15-8, 7-point lead for the Americans as we approach the second technical timeout, and we're going to see a substitution now for the Dominicans. Garcia will come in favor of Adamas.
Yeah, and Garcia's a lefty, although he approaches like a right-handed player. I saw him play last year, and a bit of an unorthodox approach, but you know, when he gets a chance to swing, he's a very effective player.
Tavana still serving for the Americans. Castillo now set for Hernandez, and Contreras will send it back over. Set Christensen. Clark trying to go down and dig for the ball, but it falls on the American side, so getting one back anyway is the Dominicans.
Yeah, a very good block there from Hernandez. He's done a really good job of reading those blocks. He's a big player. Doesn't have to jump really high to get some of those touches. Just has to make a quick decision and throw his hands into the right spot.
Hernandez, powerful serve. Pretty, though, doing a good job of controlling it. Clark sending it down, but a nice dig by Contreras. Can't get to the ball as it's well out of bounds, and they would have had to leap a sign or two.
And he just ran out of court.
Literally did. 16-9. We've hit our second technical timeout of this second set, and the Americans are starting to cruise. They're up 16-9. We'll take a quick break. Jeff Sargent, Kyle Donen back as we're out of the second technical timeout, and the U.S. has opened up a 16-9 lead in the second set after the 25-19 win in the first.
Yeah, things have kind of spread out a little bit here in the second half of this set, and the U.S. are really starting to put it to the Dominican Republic here. And again, it's their passing game. The U.S. almost seems to be getting in a bit of a rhythm on their service game, and it's making it a lot harder for the Dominican Republic to stay with them.
Micah Christensen now to serve. Towards the back of the court, Castillo first touch. Set up for Tapia, but sends it way... It was tipped out.
Off the hands.
Off the hands, 16-10. The American lead is down to 6. Still yeah. Substantial lead, though.
You know what, though? I can understand where you would know that was going on. I mean, it didn't look like it had any touch. It was just going into the crowd. But sometimes those ones just get the slightest touch.
Good eye by the officials. But the serve by Tapia, out of bounds. So they'll give the point right back. 17-10 now for the Americans. Substitution here. And Ponciano will come in for Tapia, who didn't appear to be paying attention, as we'll also see Alcantara step out.
Yeah, double sub here to put another big player in the front row, as this gives them more offense in the front row, something they need right now. They need to try and get going with as many offensive players in that front court as they can.
Anderson with the serve. Garcia now over for Caceres. Set up by Clark. Still in play. Contreras has it go out of bounds.
And he gets the touch on it, too.
He does get the tip. 17-11. So they're staying with the U.S. out of that second technical timeout. They haven't lost any ground, but they're really not gaining a whole lot either.
Unfortunately, no. They need a few more points here. Hopefully, Garcia can provide that with his serve.
As you mentioned, the lefty, we'll see it here on his serve. Clips the net. Powerful serve. Pretty sets it up. Tipped over by Clark. Tricky play at the net. Clark going, but a nice block, double block at the net for the Dominicans. Pretty tips it over towards the back of the court. Now set up on the right side. Still in play. Soji set up for Pretty, going for the kill and gets it. Nice returns there. 18-11, though. The U.S. gets the point.
Yeah, Dominican Republic just couldn't find a chance to get through a seam on some of those hits. The U.S. doing a good job of getting touches off that block, as Dominican Republic are going to take a timeout here. Kind of the last thing they can do here, as it's 18-11 for the U.S.
7-point lead, and at this point, I mean, if you're the Dominicans, you cannot make any mistakes in
this
set.
Not really, no, unfortunately. You know, it's one of those points in the match where they got to be on everything, but the tough thing is, too, they got to be aggressive. They can't just go in there and thinking, well, we got to keep the ball in play and make sure we don't make errors. If they don't go the swing to score in the way they're trying, it's going to be a very difficult point to earn. So something they got to do, they got to go and swing aggressively, and sometimes you're rewarded for that kind of swing, though. So if you go out there with that intention, you never know. If you go off those hands, that's probably your best bet, or finding that seam. You're only going to find it if you swing hard. If you don't swing with the same amount of pace, your chances of being successful aren't quite as high.
18-11 for the Americans. Max Holt serving for the United States. Castillo, first touch. Still in play. Contreras going for the kill, but it's the Americans trying to get it back in, but not quite. 18-12, and the Dominicans get a point back. They're still down by six.
Yeah, another good point after the timeout. Something they've done a really good job of. They just need to kind of build on a few of those here.
Campuchano now serving for the Dominicans. Towards the far back side of the court. Pretty after the first touch. Blocked at the net. Christensen. Ooh, a little too much on that. And the Americans tip it over. And they will get the point, though. But really, the official there kind of shaking his head at a protest by the Dominicans.
Yeah, the two veteran players going up and jousting on that ball. Usually in those cases, the ball ends up going to the side that it doesn't fall on. So with it falling on the Dominican side, it goes to the Americans.
Power serve attempt by the Americans. That was Clark a little too much, sailing it out of bounds. 19-13, side out point for the Dominicans, and serving for them now is Jose Caceres. Another lefty. No, he's not. He swung with the same arm that he threw the ball at, but it looked like. And the point will go to the Americans. Big kill towards the front of the net. 20-13, and there's that 28 point now, Kyle, and the Americans in control.
Yeah, and something they've done really well. It'll be interesting to see how they finish off this set, because they've been really solid when they've got the 20 points. And the last set, it was the same thing. Pretty got back to serve, and he's doing the same again now.
Pretty just sailing it over. Set at the front of the net. Hernandez tipped out by the Americans, so it will be point for the Dominicans. 20-14. Contreras to serve. Soji, first touch set by Christensen. Clark still in play. Hernandez going to go up for it. No, and the point will be called. A double touch by the official. So Americans getting the point and getting the ball back, 21-14.
Yeah, tough break on that one. Good touches off the block. They just looked a little disorganized as to who was going to take that second set. And once he realized he didn't have an outside hitter, he had to try and make a tough back set, which didn't work out as well as he had planned.
Futi Tavana serving for the Americans. And sails it out of bounds. Point to the Dominican, 21-15. Hernandez to serve. Soji, first touch. Clark with power gets the point, 22-15. And with a 7-point lead, the Americans closing in on the second set victory.
Yeah, a couple big aggressive swings from the Americans here at the right time, too. And, you know, we talked about it at 20 points. They've had a couple big swings to get them over that hump and now have a 22-15 lead.
Christensen towards the back. It's immediately sent back over. Pretty set by Christensen. Anderson down for the kill. Now 23-15. And with no timeouts left, the Dominicans can't really do a whole lot to slow them down, maybe a substitution or two.
Yeah, and at this point, it's tough. They did make those substitutions already, and the coach almost looks like he's not sure. He almost looks like he's contemplating what to do in that next set, whether he goes with the lineup that's out there or goes back to the original lineup that he had.
And Christensen's serve is out of bounds, so they get a point back, the Dominicans do, 23-16. Ponciano serving. Ponciano serve. Anderson first touch. Christensen and Holt gets the kill, and it is set point for the Americans, 24-16.
Yeah, and their big server will go back to try and finish it too, as Matt Anderson's had a great game from the service line. Be interesting to see what kind of a serve he decides to go with, whether he goes with all the speed he's got goes with the off-speed shot, which he's used as well.
Aggressive serve out of bounds. 24-17, still set point.
Yeah, when you're up 24-17, that's the time to go for it, see what you got, see how much you got in the tank, you could say.
And you can spare the side-out point, I suppose, in that case. High risk, and they'll get it right back anyway, as the serve from Garcia is also sent out of bounds. 25-17, the Americans have a stranglehold, 2-0 over the Dominicans. We'll take a quick break and be back with third set action live at the Langley Events Center.
Hello, volleyball fans. I'm here for the Save on Shuffle with my friends Chantel Taylor and Joelle. Tonight we have Save on Shuffle, so if you look up on the screen, you're going to see three cards pop up, and they are going to have to decide which one is the winning one after
Every
they shuffle around.
Shuffling.
So you can see the winning card is B. Now don't lose track of card B. Oh, we get a sneak peek. That was lucky. If you lost it, don't lose it again. We might get one more sneak peek. You guys still have it? Don't lose it. All right, which one do you think is the winner? They have answered C, so let's take a look. What do we think? Congratulations! It's also Taylor's 15th birthday, so she's going home with 10,000 more Save-On Rewards points in addition to McDonald's prizes. Congratulations, ladies. Enjoy the rest of the game, guys.
The Spartans win! The Spartans win!
Are you kidding me? One of the Knights is gone! You will never see!
Oh my goodness! Wow! What an exciting play!
And finally, in overtime, the team leading goal scorer rips one short side, Tom Carter
finds a perfect alone!
Score! A youngster fresh off the bench! Set up beautifully, and Panelas and a perfect hero.
Make any changes on the American side, and I don't know why you would change anything. A strong lineup, they've been doing really well. We don't really know if that's their actual starting lineup or not, as they've had a few different switches for who's been in, who's been out, but so far they've been very solid in the two sets they played so far.
And like you say, Garcia to start with the serve for the Dominicans. set they need to win. First touch by Matt Anderson. Set by Pretty and gets the kill just inside back end of the court. Point to the Americans to start out 1-0.
Yeah, strong first swing there for Pretty. As he'll go back to serve now against something he's done really well all match long. He's really controlled his serve. Different paces, and it's given a lot of trouble to the Dominican Republic.
Hard serve, Castillo. Now set up by Kabula. Tapia. Pretty first touch. Now set by Christensen. And over. Nice play at the net by Christensen. Kabula sets it for Tapia. Going for the kill. Soji first touch. Pretty sets it up towards the net. Double touch, though, ruled by the official. Pretty's going to complain about that.
Yeah, Pretty doesn't like that one. It didn't look like there was anything wrong with that set, especially when it's in a rally and in something that case. Usually you don't see something like that call. If it's one of the earlier touches, maybe. But definitely looked relatively clean. But again, it's the discretion of the referee when it comes down to a play like that.
Christensen sets the net to Vanna, and there's that power again. Getting the kill, 2-1 for the Americans.
Yeah, a couple good swings there from Tavana. He seems like he's been a quiet, calm, cool player, but every once in a while he gets that big kill and gives some momentum to the U.S.
Tavana. Towards the back of the court. Nice block by Clark. Or make that Holt. Tapia taps it over. Set up for Holt. Anderson goes down and gets the kill. And the U.S. gets the point. 3-1. They've gone up by two.
Yeah, they've taken a bit of an advantage here as Tavana's been giving them a little bit of trouble with his serve. It looks deceivingly difficult. It comes off usually with very little spin on his float serve.
Tavana serving again. Set at the front of the net. Tapia towards the back. Pretty. It's going to be set back to the front. Anderson going for the kill. Still kept in. Nice dig by Garcia. Tapia over the net once again. Christensen set for Anderson. Another block by Hernandez. But out of bounds and the U.S. getting the point. 4-1. They've opened up a three-point lead early.
Yeah, they've come out of the gates here really strong. You know, that third set's always the toughest one to win, and getting a good start like this is only going to make it a little bit easier for them.
Tapia. Make that, Tavana. Tapia will likely get a touch in here any second, but it's Hernandez who gets it this time with the kill. 4-2, Dominicans.
As Hernandez.
There's Tapia.
There he is. There he is. He's going back to serve.
Tapia serving, yes, for the Dominican Republic. Done great work, though, at the front of the net for the Dominicans. Christensen set for Holt. Nice kill. Castillo will pause there. He's not sure. He's just a little short. 5-2. He was just short of where the ball landed there, and he knew it.
That's a big swing from Holt in the middle. A tough ball for Hernandez. He looked like he got caught guessing the wrong way, but he's done a really good job of making those decisions, and sometimes you got to give those shots.
Anderson going for the point and finds a huge gaping hole in the back of the court. Dominicans caught a little out of position, perhaps. 6-2, the U.S. opening up this four-point lead now. Micah Christensen to serve for the Americans. Powerful serve, Garcia, first touch. Now Tapia sends it way out of bounds. U.S. gets the point, and now a 7-2 lead for the Americans.
Yeah, some early passing struggles here for the Dominican Republic. Bringing Garcia, and he's a good offensive player, but he struggles at times with his passing game, and so far the Americans have been going after him.
Garcia, first touch set for Hernandez. And just inside, point goes to the Dominicans, and a big point at that. 7-3 for the United States.
That wasn't the big swing that Hernandez wanted, but he found the spot he was looking for. As he's been one spot on the Dominican Republic side that has consistently been able to get balls to go down. He's got 6 kills on the night. He's got 2 big blocks as well.
Anderson off the first touch. He sends it back over as well. Tapia, play at the net by Holt. Hernandez, nice block by Holt. And that'll give the Americans the point and the ball. And that brings us to our first technical timeout of the first set with the Americans up 8-3. We'll take a quick break here live at the LEC.
Thank you, Brian. I have saved the best goodies for last. So if you guys are excited to be here, I have free t-shirts. Let me hear you cheer if you want them.
Put your hands up in the air. 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 Put your hands.
Anyone over on this side want a free t-shirt?
In the air. Put your hands up in the air. Put your hands up in the air.
And that's all I got. Enjoy the rest of the game, guys.
So the U.S. up 8-3 out of this first technical timeout of the third set. And the biggest lead that they've had to this point of any of the three sets so far.
Now this is the biggest separation we've seen between these two teams. And it almost looks like the Dominican Republic are running out of steam. But also credit to the American side too. They've served really tough in this set. They've come out aggressively, and so far it's been really tough for Dominican Republic to stay with them.
Anderson, net serve, 8-4 for the U.S., and the Dominicans will get the ball back. Hernandez will serve. Soji, first touch. Christensen set, tap over by Holt, still in play. Tapia going for the kill, kept in play, and the Americans will get the point there.
That looks like they're calling him under the net on that play. He doesn't like the call, but unfortunately there's nothing he can do about it
at
this point.
He can complain. It's not going to change it.
No, unfortunately not. Usually it doesn't go in your favor when you attempt to make a change, but Alcantara wasn't going to go down without a fight, I guess.
So the U.S. now up 9-4. Holt serving. Play at the front of the net in Tavana. Using that size, 10-4 now the Americans, and the Dominicans still won't use their timeout. They have 2 left still in this third set. Oh, now they are.
Good call, Jeff. Very good call.
They heard me, maybe. It took them a little while, but you're down 2 sets to none. You're down by 6 in the third. What is the message right now from the Dominican coach?
Well, you know what? I think they got to keep pushing. You know, even if they don't come back in this, this is a whole tournament. That's the perspective that I think you got to look at too. You know, building momentum. This is their first match of the tournament, and again, we said it earlier, a tough opponent to go after in that first match to kind of get your feet wet. But you know what? I've been really impressed with what they've shown, especially with the young group that they've got, and I think they could pose a threat in that quarterfinal match, depending on how they do tomorrow as well. So, you know, anything can happen, especially when it's that younger core. And so far, they've shown what they're capable of.
So coming out of that timeout taken by the Dominicans, Holt still holding serve. Gets it over. Alcantara set for Tapia, who gets the kill. And he has... I haven't seen the stats there. I don't know if you can tell me, Kyle, but Tapia has really probably led the way in kills for the Dominicans.
He sure has. You're bang on. He's got 9 kills on the night. He does lead the team in with 9 kills. I mean, that's one thing the Dominicans have done really well, actually, looking at their overall stats. They've really spread the ball out well when they've been in trouble. And, you know, at this level, you can't rely on that one big player, that one big hitter, because at this level, it's too easy to find them all the time and realize that that's the go-to player. So the top teams, they do a really good job of spreading their offense out. I mean, you do the same thing. You look at the Americans. They've got Pretty, who leads the way with 10, but then it goes, you know, like 8, 6, 7 for each of the other players. It's very spread out for these between these two teams.
U.S. now really cruising, 12-5, and they hold serve. It's Clark. Sends it across. Alcantara, nice block by Tavana. Had to get back in position, though. Still in play. Garcia sends it out of bounds. But point will go to the Dominican Republic. Yes. So 12-6.
And the Dominican Republic also made a small other change in their starting lineup. Didn't see it till now because he switched off with the libero right away, but Frias is in the middle for the Dominican.
Garcia now serving for the Dominicans, but out of bounds. Americans get the point back, 13-6. And now the U.S. will make a substitution. Looks like Jeffrey Menzel will come in favor of Matt Anderson.
Yeah, so Menzel saw some action yesterday, too, I believe, in their first match. And he looked very strong, and now he's going to get a chance to potentially close out the match for the U.S.
And Pretty sends it over, and the Dominicans just having trouble receiving the serve, 14-6. The U.S. up. Pretty holds the serve. And it looks like maybe the Dominicans getting ready after this to make a substitution of their own. Castillo, Alcantara, tipped out of bounds by the Americans, so a point given to the Dominican Republic, 14-7 the score, U.S. in the lead.
And Frias gets on the board with his first kill of the match coming in.
And he'll have his first serve attempt of the match. Soji. Set for Tavana. Point for the Americans. 15-7. Tavana now will serve. And with a point, this would take us to our second technical timeout. Garcia, Alcantara. Set up for Tapia, just getting it in. Nicely done. He finds that back corner. 15-8.
Yeah, Tapia's had a very strong game for the Dominican Republic. He's been a good release player on that right side. He's done a really good job of using those hands when he can and finding the floor as well.
And Tapia in double-digit kills serving. Christensen sets for Menzel, just getting it in, and the U.S. gets the point, 16-8 at our second technical timeout of this third set. And we'll take a brief break here before we continue live at NORCECA 2013.
Looking like it may be the last handout of the night, so I have some Team Canada water bottles for people who get up on their feet and cheer. I know it's been a long night, but I still want to hear you. Yeah, do you guys want some of this? There we go. They kind of fly a bit funny, so you're going to have to try and see what you can do. Anyone want a water bottle? Yeah? And what about a t-shirt? I still have a couple of those. Oh, yeah, that's what you were holding out for. Oh, sorry, guys. What about anyone over on this side? We want to share love. Yeah, right over here. That's courtesy of some of the girls on the other side. Here we go. Here's another one. This is a small. You know you want the small.
U.S. up 16-8 in this third set. Took the first, 25-19, 25-17 in the second. And the Dominican, this is their first match. So they still have to play yet again tomorrow. But, you know, at this point, Kyle, they know that they're in some serious trouble here today.
Yeah, I think they've come up against a very strong opponent, and, you know, again, because this is their first match and the U.S. did play their match yesterday, it's a little bit tougher. I think the Americans have looked a little more comfortable, especially during the later stages of each of these sets, and it's starting to really show now in this third set with them up 17-8.
Christensen to serve. Towards the back of the court. Alcantara for Tapia. Out of bounds. Point to the Americans. 18-8. And at this point, the Americans looking as if maybe they won't even allow the Dominicans to reach double digits.
Well, we'll have to wait and see. It's close. I think they're going to fight a little bit harder towards the end there, try and build some momentum moving forward in the tournament.
Well, like we were saying, the Dominicans still with one match to go. St. Lucia up tomorrow for them. And, like you say, I guess just build some momentum going into that match.
Yeah, it's going to be, I think it'll be a good day tomorrow. Tomorrow is the final day of pool play again. St. Lucia plays the Dominican Republic. Then the Bahamas takes on Puerto Rico. And, of course, the feature match at 8 o'clock. We have the Canada. Right? We have Canada. We have Canada taking on Mexico, which will most likely be the last match that determines who will be in those semifinal spots heading into Friday.
So coming out of that timeout by the Dominicans. Christensen to serve. Garcia first touch. Alcantara. Tapia. Nice block. Holt. 19-8. And the U.S. retains the serve for Christensen.
Yeah, and as you can see there, Alcantara trying to force a few sets to his right side player, and the U.S. are starting to clamp down on Tapia, who's had a very strong match, but when those two blocks are guessing right and in the right spots to make that block, it's a tough one to go around.
Alcantara, block at the front of the net. Americans, Clark, 20-8 now. The Americans have hit the 20-point mark. They lead by 12. And that fight is going to have to start pretty soon here for the Dominicans.
Yeah, it's not looking so good down the stretch here. 20-8, as you said. And Christensen's been serving really well for the U.S.
And he did yesterday as well. And see, again, they have trouble with the receiving the serve as it's right over. And Menzel will get the kill. 21-8. Substitution now for the Dominicans. Segura will come in. Coming out, Luis Adamas. Christensen still with the serve. Cruising along. Towards the back of the court. Tapia gets it back to midcourt. Now the Americans set up for Christensen and Holt with the kill. 22-8. Christensen serves again, so he's been on a nice roll.
Yeah, he's had a very good tournament for serving so far, as you mentioned. Very solid yesterday in the service line. And it's always something you like to see, your setter serving strong, because if you can hold points there, you keep all three hitters in the front row even longer, and he gets another one there.
Beautiful service ace at the back of the court, 23-8. And maybe the Dominicans won't reach double digits after all.
Possibly, and we're just a couple points away from finishing off day number two.
Christensen, though, sends it straight into the net after a nice run of serves. 23-9, Dominicans get the ball. Segura serving. First serve attempt for him today. Late. Gets it over cleanly. Set by Christensen. Menzel. Mishandled by Castillo. Now it is match point with the U.S. up 24-9.
Set and match point. Serving will be number 14, Menzel.
Jeffrey Menzel serving. Over for Tapia, gets it over. Americans still have it in play. Pretty sets it towards the front of the net, tapped over by Holt. Hernandez able to get it back. Garcia sends it towards the back of the court. Set by Holt. Pretty slams it down, gets the point. The Americans take it 25-9. And Kyle, they finish this one off in straight sets. 25-19, 25-17, 25-9. Improving each time and absolutely dominating in this third and final set, as it turns out.
Yeah, a bit of a surprise, I think, in the third set. It looked like the fight was gone from the Dominicans after those first two sets. And, you know, again, I said it earlier, I give the Dominican a lot of credit. They played very well in that first set, and they were right with them in the second set most of the way until the U.S. really pulled away from them. But, you know, the U.S. put themselves in a good spot to most likely be in that semifinal position, winning three straight again. And with Cuba's three sets to one win over Puerto Rico, most likely what happens with Canada and Mexico will overall determine who takes that second semifinal spot.
So Canada still lots to play for. Again, they can save themselves a match if tomorrow against Mexico they are able to keep the points against down. And yesterday the Americans did allow a few more points already. So Canada going into that match with Mexico with a bit of an advantage, but the Americans doing very well in that third set. And they now with, a bit of a rest. They will not play tomorrow, will the United States. The Dominicans, though, with another match left to go. And what's their mindset going to be at here going into their final match against St. Lucia?
Well, I think they do a lot of the same things they did tonight. You know, they had a relatively solid match tonight. And obviously a very different opponent when they'll take on St. Lucia tomorrow. It'll probably be a little bit closer, and, you know, it's a different level to play at, I think. But I'd expect the Dominican Republic to come out on top. I think they are the stronger team from what we've seen so far in the tournament. But again, anything can happen, and it's really for something. You come out in that second spot, and you're going to have a chance to go into the quarterfinals. So something to definitely play for those teams. And it'll be the same scenario for Puerto Rico and the Bahamas. So tomorrow is a day that means a lot, especially for Canada. If they can win in three sets, most likely we're going to see them in the semifinals.